My name is Doug Parker with the Cruise Radio Podcast, and this is a tour of Norwegian Cruise Line's Great Stirrup Cay. Before we get to the tour, if you like this video and you'd like to see more videos, subscribe to the channel and give the video a thumbs up. So Great Stirrup Cay is a 268-acre island located in the Berry Islands, and in 1977, Norwegian Cruise Line purchased the land from an oil company and transformed it into their own private cruise destination. Since then, the island has been constantly evolving. The island itself is actually located next to Royal Caribbean's Perfect Day at Coco Cay. Actually, the two islands are only about 1,500 feet apart or so. Over the past couple of years, Great Stirrup Cay has been undergoing a major renovation that has seen adding a lighthouse, zip lines, a couple of new food outlets, and an entirely new high-end section called Silver Cove. Now, you won't find water slides, pools, or hot air balloons here. Instead, Great Stirrup Cay puts an emphasis on what you come to expect when you think of the Bahamas, which is white sand and blue waters. Although NCL does have plans to build a pier at Great Stirrup Cay, for the time being, you still have to take a tender boat to the island. That means that the ship will anchor offshore and you'll board a smaller boat for the short trip over to Great Stirrup. A bit of advice though, once you board the ship, find out when they make tender tickets available because you'll want to get on the earliest one possible for two reasons. One, it gives you more time to enjoy the island, but secondly, the early bird does get the worm. Also, especially on the larger ships like those on the Breakaway and Breakaway Plus class, the tendering process can take a long time. On a recent sailing, those left with the latest tender tickets didn't even get to the island until after 2 o'clock, and we had to be back on the ship by 5:30. So yeah, the early bird gets the worm here. Once you dock at Great Stirrup Cay, you'll be on the north side of the island and you'll follow a path that leads to the main entrance. Now from there, you'll see signs that point out various destinations. If you have a shore excursion book or have rented a private cabana for the day, you'll head directly to the tour information desk and they'll get you set up. They'll also be able to answer any questions you might have about the island or just point you in the right direction for where you want to go. Shore excursion-wise, there are all kinds of options available, from snorkeling to swimming with pigs, and of course, there are the newly opened zip lines. If you're a daredevil looking to zip line off the top of a lighthouse, the cost is $59 per adult, $39 for children, and if you forgot your closed-toed shoes for the zip line, they'll rent you a pair for $5. Now, just ahead, you'll find the main beach, and this is where most people immediately head. Many of them will have reserved clamshells and umbrellas in advance. If you have failed to do this, you can always find out if there are still some available when you arrive, but often they sell out pretty quickly because it does get pretty hot on the island. But in this general area, you're also going to find the main buffet staging area, as well as the very popular Bacardi bar. The Bacardi bar will become party central as the afternoon goes on, with the drinks flowing, the music pumping, and yes, you can even use your drink package on the island here. Now, while the Bacardi bar tends to be the most popular bar and the most crowded, there are plenty of other watering holes on the island. The Lighthouse bar offers a bit more shade than some of the other ones and is as rarely as busy as some of the other ones as well. A great place to stop for a drink. If you're facing the water and you walk to the right, you'll find the Straw Market. This is the shopping area, but beware, if you want to buy anything here, you're going to need cash. This is one place on the island that they do not accept your key card. This area also contains the new Abaco Taco Hut. Just like the name implies, this place has tacos, tacos, and more tacos. They give you flour tortillas filled with beef or chicken. Then you can add your own toppings here. A lot of the folks weren't really aware that this place exists, so it's usually not very crowded. But then after you get your tacos, you can head over to the Patron Bar and get yourself a margarita. Now, there's not a lot of shade to be found on this main beach, and it can get pretty crowded, but you can find more shade and fewer people by walking further down the beach. Use the lighthouse, which can be seen from just about anywhere on the island, as your guide. If you're on the main beach and you want to go somewhere a bit more peaceful, just walk towards the lighthouse and then beyond, and it kind of thins out a little bit. Now, once you pass the lighthouse, you'll find yourself on a wide paved path. Just off this path, sitting on a slight hill, you'll see what are known as the large cabanas. These cabanas have a nice view of the water and plenty of room for your group to relax in. But truth be told, the small cabanas, which are going to be what we pass if we keep moving forward, are better to book. Why? Because they're located on a smaller, more private beach. And by the way, these aren't the big splashy new villas you've probably heard about. Those are over in Silver Cove, which we're going to talk about in just a minute. Now, this smaller, quieter beach does have a few drawbacks. For one thing, it's a bit of a hike to the main area, which is where you'll find most of the food and bars. But if you get on one of those first tenders, you can come over here to the quiet beach, do some swimming, and then head over to the main area for lunch. And speaking of lunch, the place that most people head is the buffet we mentioned earlier, the Jumbi Beach Grill. It offers pretty much what you'll expect to find at buffets on the private islands. You'll find burgers, hot dogs, grilled chicken, salads, and an assortment of other foods. If you want a burger or a hot dog but don't want to wait in line at the buffet, check to see if there are separate grilling stations nearby. Sometimes there's a burger stand or a hot dog stand located close by. Seating-wise, there's a ton of it, and it's covered, which makes it a great place to take a break from the heat while you're chowing down on your lunch. Closer to the quieter beach, there is a recently added food truck called Drop It Like It's Hot. Oh, I see what they did there, like the Snoop Dogg song, Drop It Like It's Okay, whatever. They offer limited menu items like pulled pork or mahi sandwiches, Baja spiced chicken, even rum cakes for desserts. Like the buffet, this is also included in your cruise fare. If you keep walking, you're going to come to the new area called Silver Cove. This is the new high-end area on Great Stirrup Cay, and it definitely puts the private and private island, as Richard said on a recent episode of the Cruise Radio podcast, if the Haven is a ship within a ship, then Silver Cove is an island within an island, or something like that. Let's see what he really said.
If the Haven is a ship within a ship, this is sort of an island within an island.
And like the Haven, you won't be able to visit Silver Cove unless you've rented one of the nearly 40 villas circling this beautiful private lagoon. And let me tell you, these villas are something else. They range in size from studios to two-bedroom villas. Each one is fully enclosed, air conditioning, beautifully decorated. They also feature a television with on-demand programming and full bathrooms. And there's also a staff member there to make sure you have everything you need. And while the main beach has the Patron Bar, over here in Fantasyland, they have the Moet Champagne Bar, where a glass of bubbly will set you back $25. But hey, if you're living that large Silver Cove life, you're not asking how much a glass of champagne is, right? So how much do these Silver Cove villas cost? Well, the price will vary by sailing in season, but the ballpark figure that was quoted to me ranged from $299 to $699 for the studio villas. One-bedroom villas will go between $349 and $799, and the two-bedroom villas are currently going for between $599 and $1,100. Now, keep in mind, these prices are per villa, not per person. You may think that $1,100 seems a little high for a two-bedroom villa, but if you think about it, 16 people can actually come here, so that's what, about $70 roughly per person? So it's really not that bad if you think about it and the access you get to the cove and all of that. The fact that Silver Cove features these villas with actual bedrooms has sparked a lot of speculation that once NCL completes the Great Stirrup Cay Pier, they might start doing overnights on the island. And that would actually make more sense to have it overnight than just 8 hours while you're there on the island. One way to get a sneak peek at Silver Cove without actually staying in one of the villas is to make an appointment at the island's Mandara Spa. Although this is smaller than the one you'll find on the ship, the spa is a great place to get a massage while you're literally looking at the ocean. The treatment rooms overlook the water. There's a big whirlpool out here and just a patio that overlooks the ocean. Just awesome. You can make your appointments when you're on the ship if you want to head out to the Mandara Spa when you're on Great Stirrup. All right, so a few final tips to help you maximize your visit to Great Stirrup Cay. Bring a little cash, not only for tipping the bartenders, but also if you want to do any shopping at the straw market. Remember, they do not take your key card there. Visit the Shore Excursions desk on board to make arrangements in advance for anything you want to do on the island. You'd rather wait in line on the ship than in the hot sun once you're there. Make sure you bring plenty of sunblock. It can get pretty hot on the island, and shade can be tough to find. If you do want protection from the sun, rent a clamshell in advance. And if you want to rely on Mother Nature to keep you shaded, there are some loungers under the trees halfway between the main beach and the smaller, more private one, but they do go fast, so you have to find them first. Also, when you board the tender boat to head back to the cruise ship, keep in mind that they usually wait until it's almost full before they leave to go back to the ship, and it's a two-deck tender boat, so if you're hot and sun-drenched, you may want to sit on the bottom deck and not the top exposed deck. And finally, get on the earliest tender you can in order to get to the island early. Get that tender ticket. Sign up for it as soon as you get on the ship to make the most out of your day at Great Stirrup Cay. All right, there you have it, your tour of Great Stirrup Cay. My name is Doug Parker. I'm the host of the Cruise Radio podcast and the daily Cruise Radio news briefs. You can find both of those where you listen to your favorite podcast. Just search Cruise Radio or Cruise Radio News. If you like these videos and you'd like to see more content, subscribe to the channel and give the video a thumbs up. You're the reason why I do make these videos. So what do you think about Great Stirrup Cay and the new Silver Cove addition to the island? Let me know in the comments below, and thank you so much for watching.